Hey guys, I'm here with the final piece, yet not final video, of the Transformers Collectors Club Combiner Series, as I'm probably going to call it from now on. Here is the 2009 figure of Heatwave. Yes, there's a big gaping head right there, and if you look closely inside, look, there's another head. It's hiding in there. It's hiding, but trust me, it's there. Oh, there he is! Okay, anyway. Heatwave is a remold of Energon Barricade. I believe it was Barricade. Was it Barricade? I think it was Barricade. Yeah, I think it was Barricade. Who was a rename of Onslaught, I think. I don't know. But they were used to make the Energon Combiner team of Bruticus Maximus, I think. I don't know. I'm going off the top of my head here. Not a bad little thing. You notice he is kind of big compared to the others. It's just his vehicle mode. The other figures are basics. I believe he is more of a deluxe size figure. He is a missile launcher truck, apparently to Wikipedia, that is similar to an Astros 2 MLRS. He does have a missile launcher in the back. It can rotate full 360. It can pivot up and down. It's universal. You know, you can even make kind of pretend that he's got booster rockets and he's just if you really want to, but I don't. So we're not going to do that. Definitely not. It's not horrible. Lots of translucenty goodness all through the front here. Lots of purple, lots of red. You got some purple in the back. Lots of nice little goofy stuff there. Not sure I'm talking like that. It's okay. It's, you know, it's bad that his head is visible. It'd be nice if they had panels to cover this section, but, you know, oh well. On the front, you have an upside-down Decepticon symbol, which my camera is probably not going to pick up on because it doesn't want to. Trust me, it's there. Oh, wait, look. You don't have to trust me. See, it's there. It's just upside down. Yet his robot mode has a kind of different symbol. So to transform no heatwave here, pull back on the missile system. You're going to swing it down, and it's on this little hinge, so kind of pivot it forward, and it should lock into the lower portion of the truck. It locks fairly well. It's not perfect, but it does hold fairly nicely. Separate the missile section, and then rotate them. Okay, so you got this. Take the bottom portion, flip it up, and it'll become a foot like this. Yeah. Now, you do see these giant pegs. Cool thing with the Energon Combiners is that they all have universal joints. There's one kind of style. You're going to have one deluxe figure that'll be the torso, the head, and I guess you could even say the thighs, I guess. But, and they all have these little pegs. There's going to be two more which are located right in here. So then you have these four basic figures that can be, you know, that can kind of be put on any of those pegs. Most of them, if not all, are kind of universal. They both have a foot mode, they both have an arm mode, or a leg and arm mode. And you can swap around all the pieces, which is a kind of cool little nifty thing. So if you don't like the configuration of Nexus Maximus when he's put together, you can go through your other Energon Combiners and mix and match. Of course, you're not going to have the translucency goodness, but hey, it works. But anyway, so the pegs are kind of exposed. You don't want to have that. So over these little back black tabs, I already did that, and you're going to swing the leg down. There is a little peg right here, a little slot right here. Just tab that in. It does add to the stability quite a bit. And then close the black tabs up. And you can see he's got feedums. Yes! Next, take the front section and just fold it backwards. Now this I'm going to have a kind of an issue with when I get to it. The instructions are just really basic and it doesn't seem to tell me what I want to know, but we'll get there. So you got this, fold his arms up, fold the shoulders down like this. Other one didn't really go all the way, but fold the shoulders down, rotate the arms so the elbows are in the front, and then get them down. Get him down. Okay, then take his head, pop it in place. Okay, now here this back section. The instructions basically go in this scenario, while the arms are still raised, mind you. fold this flat against his back. Okay, well, I did that. Okay, nice. Now, take this piece and fold it up like this, and it should lock in place against his back. Well, that's hunky-dory. I can get it to hold like this. Which, actually, that really happens. But it doesn't feel right to me. There is a little tiny tab right in here and a little slot. Those fit together. They don't really lock in place like I think they should. And there's a little tab here that fits to a slot here. Those do not fit together at all. It buckles out the sides here. So let's try opening that up. But you can hear that. Okay, listen. There's a lot of like just grinding together type noises. So I'm not sure if I'm just doing it wrong. If I'm, if they're kind of just that way. But just kind of work with it. If you get it to fit somewhat reasonable, that's how it looks in the instructions, something like that. He has a giant hunchback. Go for it. It works. And then you have Heatwave. Heatwave has about the same articulation as the others. The head does have a full 360. He does have some decent light piping in his eyes. I'm not sure how well you can really see that, but he's got it. His head looks pretty nice. I like his little head. Arms have full movements. They can pivot outwards. Elbow has a joint. The wrist does not turn, but it does turn at the elbow, so you can do some things. He does not have any weapons, which I don't think any of the actual deluxe size figures had weapons. The legs can move upwards. They can pivot outwards. He has knees, although you have to kind of grab the top and bottom together. Otherwise, you will kind of do this, and that's not how it's supposed to be. You're supposed to have the whole knee moving. And that's really about it. Oh, he also has hip movements. Woohoo. Now, this is the kind of odd thing. I'm going to end it about here. Because next is the whole combination thing. You saw he has the regular Decepticon logo and his vehicle mode. Well, his robot mode has the shattered glass Decepticon logo. If my camera will actually show, it's really bright and it's not probably going to show up, but what are you going to do? Here, there you go. If I kind of shield it there. It's got the shattered glass Decepticon logo. I have seen some websites that say these guys are kind of in the classics line, which I definitely don't see. I see some say they're from the Timelines story, and I have not read the Timelines comics yet. But this places Heatwave in the Shattered Glass universe, so I'm kind of confused on the whole thingy-jingy about who goes where. But regardless, he definitely does look pretty nice to get him standing up. In terms of his translucence, he really doesn't have a whole lot in his robot mode. He has a lot more for his vehicles, you can probably tell. That's all translucent, except for this little black piece. But that is all translucent. This section here, it is translucent, but there's some painted on black, and there's some solid parts in there, so it kind of, you don't really get the full effect going. And that's really about it. His legs and arms have nothing at all. But that is it. Here he is with a comparison next to the others. He is kind of a hunchback, so he's back heavy. Which doesn't help that my table's not really very even. I think I need a new bookcase. You guys want to buy me a new bookcase? It'd be handy. So here's Landquake. Here's Skyfall. I really just can't see him. I will zoom out momentarily. There's Breakaway. And here is Topspin, who I think is still my favorite in terms of vehicle and robot modes. So there is your Club Combiner. I've not been a member of the club for 5 years. I've been a member for about 2. But just keep in mind, those who have been on this kind of went through quite a bit of waiting, because you're looking at 5 years worth of figures. They look nice, though. But that is it. I'm going to go. Hope you guys enjoyed the video. Hope you have a great day, and I will see you around. Take care.